Niet één liedje in dit programma is willekeurig gekozen. Allemaal met liefde en zorg. Soms om een reden. Soms gewoon omdat het prachtig is. Maar in dit geval Alanis Morissette. En Thank You. Speciaal gedraaid voor Jade Bird. Want die is hier, die heeft net een fantastisch liedje gespeeld. I Get No Joy. Ze gaat zometeen nog een nummer voor ons spelen. But you've been a huge fan of Alanis Morissette, right? She's been an inspiration for you.
Yeah, you look a little bit like Alanis.
Really?
Yeah, I was just thinking. You've got a little bit of the brunette, the like feistiest of compliment. I think she's like stunning. So yeah. But I've been a huge fan of hers since I was a kid, you know. But it just kind of means more, that album, when you grow up a bit as a woman, I think. It just attaches to you in a whole new way. So yeah, I love that record.
This Thank You, is this particular song...
Yeah.
What does that mean to you?
I mean, it's classic Alanis Morissette writing. I mean, I like it because it's not on the Jagged Little Pill album, and I've kind of hammered that album, you know, all the time.
Yeah, same here.
And it's just so pretty. It's like, thank you, India. It's just an amazing tune, really. It's awesome.
And yeah, what I really loved about it after Jagged Little Pill is that she sounded kind of happy and at peace.
Yeah.
So I was really happy for her when this song came out.
Yeah, very true. I didn't realize she wrote Jagged Little Pill at 21. That blew my mind off. 21 years, that's my age.
Yeah, but, well, talking about you, you were very young when you knew what you wanted as well, because what's kind of fascinating about your life and career is your determination and perseverance.
Yeah.
Because you unsuccessfully applied at the Brit school at the age of 16.
Yeah.
But got accepted at the second attempt.
Yeah. Yeah, I wasn't taking no no's for an answer. Yeah, no, I've always been like that. My mum's quite similar, same as my grandma. My mum's kind of got this incredible strength. I don't know where it comes from. She kind of brought me up pretty much by herself, and I've always just watched her as a shining example of how to do things, and not giving up was definitely one of the, you know, one of the lessons I took.
But 16 also is very young, right, to apply to that school?
No, surprisingly not. People go there from 14 to 18. So, yeah, but it's harder to get in when you're 16 because the spaces are smaller. Because some people go at 14, it's a little easier. But 16 is a bit of a competitive age. It's just, in the UK, it's really hard to find places that support the arts that aren't privately funded, not to get deep. But
we can get deep. you know? Can swear and get deep.
Oh, sick! That's FM. Great. Yeah. Not that I've trained myself now not to swear. But yeah, they don't really. There's not a lot of funding for the arts, so that's kind of a real competitive place for that reason. Yeah.
So the arts in general are more for the elite.
I mean, that's probably a bigger topic, but they're certainly, I feel, less focused on in public schools. You know, and that's why Brit is so rare, because you don't have to pay to go there. And that's why it's so popular. So yeah. It's definitely not a fame school, as I think a lot of people assume. You know?
Yeah, always when you hear about Brit school, you hear the names of Adele and Amy Winehouse.
Yeah. But you forget them girls came from very like humble backgrounds. They were in the middle of London, like family worked really hard. They didn't necessarily, you know what I mean? They didn't really come from like a whole lot of money, and that's because the school was, you know, publicly funded type of thing. So although it might look all glitzy and shiny, you know, it's not that way.
I read this article in which it said you'd rather not co-write with others.
Yeah.
Could you elaborate on that?
Well, basically, I kind of said that there's a lot of co-writing in music right now, especially in the pop circuit. And basically, I just wanted to try and write this album on my own. I thought, you know, it's a bit of a statement these days. And I just wanted to say what I wanted to say undiluted. I didn't want anyone telling me how to feel, or, you know, because there's a lot of, I basically said a quote of like guys kind of writing with young women. And if you write a song about how you feel as a young woman, to me, it didn't really make much sense. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because it's like, I was a guy, I meant to know how I feel when I'm 21. and a young female. So yeah, that's kind of what I meant by that. But I think co-writing with artists can be a great thing. You know, I've really want to do some collaboration on my next album. I've got this kind of, don't know, the next album jitters.
Do you know with whom? If you can dream big?
Well, I don't know. I don't necessarily think it's like the stars. I think there can be a lot to be said in humble collaboration. For example, I saw Julia Jacklin. She's an Australian artist, and I crossed paths with her in Shaky Knees and watched her set, and there's something very pure and very like strong about her. She sings quite you know, soft music, but it's very, very strong in its message. So I think a collaboration with her would be wonderful on my next record. We'll see. We'll see how it all pans out.
I have the feeling you really like strong women.
Yeah, I do. And I believe in kind of raising women who don't necessarily feel that, because I've been fortunate. I've got a mum who's like, you know, pretty badass mama. But, you know, equally, my whole point, the reason why I play live and, you know, talk like this is because I'd love for any girl who doesn't feel like they necessarily can watch someone and feel like they could too. You know what I mean? So I think it's raising women up, and I think it's our time in a way. I really do believe that.